Ready?
Hi, my name is Sylvia.
My name is Calvin.
And I'm Angela.
And we are...
OG Spoosh Bags.
Yeah.
This video is called Manchu Manchu.
Cue music!
So many of you are probably wondering, who are the Manchus? Well, the Manchus were originally called Jurchens. They were formed when the Ming Dynasty fell due to economic crisis and the Qing Dynasty took over by their first emperor, Nurhaci. Manchurians are a pretty big minority. As of 2010, there are 10.4 million Manchurians living in China, compared to Ireland, where there's only 4.5 million people in the whole country. The Manchus are situated in northeast China as of the early 1600s. Then they started to expand down south, and by the late 1600s, Manchurians have conquered all of China and Mongolia. Manchurians are heavily influenced by Mongolia. The influences include the alphabet, fashion, and the uses of horse and archers. Manchurian women wore their hair up and high. This is called Liangbaotou, which means two heads. They also wore dresses called qipao. Qipao was made from silk with beautiful hand-stitched patterns. While men had the front of their heads shaved, and they grew out the back of their hair, and they braided it. This was called sankoho, which means pig's tail. Men wore hanfu, which is similar to qipao, with many layers. Manchurians have traditions for nearly everything they do. For example, in Manchurian weddings, the celebration lasts for 3 days. The first day is called killing pigs. This is for the preparation of work. The second day is called walking the sustained chair, which means that the chair of the bridal was brought to circle the village, then return home while the groom worships his ancestors. Then on the third day is the wedding ceremony. Laba festival is one of the festivals celebrated by Manchurians. This is celebrated on the 8th day of the 12th lunar month. It is celebrated to honor Buddha and also to celebrate a successful year of harvest. Other festivals include the Spring Festival and Panjin Festival. If you are planning to visit China and experience the life of Manchurians, you can always visit Harbin, Changchun, and Cheyang. You can visit the Forbidden City in Beijing. This is the birth of the Ming and Qing Dynasty. Many people that were born inside the walls have never set foot outside the walls of the Forbidden City. This city took 14 years to build and has over 14 million visitors a year.
Most of the Manchu people are situated in the north of China. The north of China is really mountainous and rocky. And as a result, they were able to produce coal and steel at a very large rate. Another agriculture export that they had was cotton as well. It was only mediocre quality cotton, but it was still cotton. During the World War II period, the Japanese people ruled over the Manchu people. As a result, they built really big factories and industry, so they were able to get the economy booming after World War II. For agriculture, the Manchu people harvest opium poppies. The bud in the opium poppies was called opium, and they were smoked for recreational purposes. Opium poppies were the main export for the Manchu people until the 1960s, before they were banned by the Chinese government. Other products include soy, maize, and wheat, and as they were harvested at a much smaller basis. The Manchu people lived in bricked houses with slated roofs. When you enter a Manchu home, there's the kitchen, and it has rooms on the side and at the back. The Manchu people slept on brick beds. As the north of China was really cold, these beds were heated up by kangs. Kangs were pipes that ran under the bed that led to open fire in the center of a Manchu home. The Manchu people are mostly non-religious. There's a small minority of Buddhism, Shamanism, and Christianity. Shamanism is a really, really small minority. The shamans believed that there were spirits that haunted people, and they used to dance around and hit drums surrounding the person that's supposedly cursed. The Yongzhen Emperor was the ruler of the Qing Dynasty. This emperor brought Christianity into China, and he was said to have a pet dragon. In traditional Manchu culture, the men greeted like this, and the women greeted like this to the elderly. The average temperature for Manchu is around 13 to 15 degrees, as they're situated at the north of China. The north of China is rather cold compared to the south, and at the summer it ranges from 20 degrees, and then in the winter it goes to around minus 5 degrees. The average rainfall is around 2.5 inches per month, compared to Ireland is 3.7 inches per month. The Manchu people ate a lot of pork as that was their main source of meat. The other meat that the Manchu people had was horse, and they wouldn't eat horse as they thought of the horses as companions. It was actually illegal for the Manchu culture to kill or even, you know, skin a dog, as they found dogs as prized animals. Most of the food for the Manchu people was wheat-based, or like the Han Chinese.
Like any other culture, music is pretty important in Manchurian society. Manchu music are mainly influenced by Mongolian styles. A popular instrument in Manchu music is the octagonal drum. The octagonal drum is basically an eight-sided tambourine with bells on each side. It is played by shaking or tapping on the drum part. It is mainly played during dance. Manchurian dance is also popular and important. Since women do not bind their feet, they are able to dance freely and elegantly. Men also dance, and dance were usually in groups. In Manchu society, women were treated equal as men. There weren't a lot of discrimination between the genders. Unlike other Chinese ethnic tribes, Manchurian women did not bind their feet. They wore shoes with heels that mimic horse hooves, which looks like this. So, why are the Manchus still alive today? The Manchu people are alive today mainly by cultural survival, such as traditional clothing, language, festivals, and music.